welcome to Chanel Auto Populaire. Another maker has fallen at the sacrificial stone of the SUV. This is Alfa's first SUV in its history, and it comes when SUV deals are soaring and the organization could do with an example of overcoming adversity. Over Euro 1B and has been spent building up the new Giorgio stage that supports the Giulia, Stelvio and the mass of future RWD/4WD Alfas and Maseratis. This is time to take care of business, no reasons. In the event that it's to prop up to the organization, the Stelvio should be not only an incredible Alfa, but rather awesome full stop. There's something odd going ahead here. I've completed two laps of it by walking now, sat in both front seats, twiddled each handle, extended on the back seat and jabbed around in the boot. In any case, it's awful, I can't locate any glaring bargains, no free inside rim, no bundling bargains or electronic glitches. The main clear Alfa-ness is the outside outline, a needless gathering of bends and lumps, limited LED eyes and engaging extents. Actually, I discover it somewhat chunky from the front three-quarter point, better from the back, however it is, all things considered, an alluring thing and, for reasons unknown, unmistakably Italian. Maybe it's the red paint. That the cooking variant you see here loses little experiencing significant change from the chunkier 503bhp Quadrifoglio adaptation we saw toward the finish of a year ago, and drive into late spring, says a lot about its volumes. You sit 190 millimeters further up from the street than in the Alfa Romeo Giulia, and Alfa's Q4 all-wheel drive framework, raised drive in typical conditions, up to 50 for each penny of the power frontwards and low grasp conditions, is standard on all renditions at dispatch. A section level back drive just form will take after not long from now. This is especially a SUV intended to handle streets, maybe a rock garage at a push. Unsurprisingly, Alfa's building boss, Roberto Fedeli, once in the past of Ferrari, disclosed to us his point was to precisely replicate the Giulia and the way the Stelvio drives, a real-to-life confirmation that cutting-edge clients like the possibility of a SUV, yet don't need the roly-poly flow its higher focus of gravity carries with it. This is the thing that architects allude to as a test. Luckily, the Giulia stage with its two-fold wishbone front, multi-connect raised aluminum suspension is a decent place to begin. Springs are longer than the Giulia, yet stiffer to neutralize the additional stature. There's daintiness, as well, because of a carbon fiber prop shaft as standard, motors with aluminum squares, and aluminum skin for the hat, back end, entryways and front wings. In with no reservations, the Stelvio weighs 1,660 kilograms with liquids, that is a similar weight for fossil diesel and oil adaptations, 145 kilograms not as much as an equal BMW X3 and 185 kilograms not exactly a fossil Porsche Macan. The establishments, at that point, are sound.
See the girl like her, and I won't waste that chance.